Right. Good night, everybody. Welcome to FGC Podcast, episode 13. That's 13 weeks now, going strong. And we have a few topics to talk about tonight. Just three quick ones. We have some events coming up and stuff. And the guys here have some questions they want to get off their chest and stuff. So we'll get to that in a little bit. But first, let me get to the introductions. We have the man behind the mic, Mr. Dre Gruff. Welcome here. What's up, dude? From Fraud Squad, we have two members tonight. Double R.
Yeah, what are you saying, fellas?
And
Mr.
Calvin. Yeah, what's up?
And representing Smash, we have Mr. Emilio Hicks, Milo.
Oi.
And DOG of the old school games. So let's see what I do there. DOG. Okay. All right, okay.
Yeah,
Mr. Dog. With us again for another week.
Yeah, fellas, what is this scene?
Alright, we'll be joined by Mr. Jason Brown, Alpha, in a little while to plug his event gate. So we'll start off with the Boogie Sweat qualifier that happened a couple weeks ago.
Cool.
Yeah, it was a qualifier for
the... Qualifier 40.
Sorry. Might need to mute the stream. Okay. All right, Jason joining us now. Jason, go ahead and shut yourself out.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, yeah. We're talking about the Boogie Sweat, the qualifier for the Gate tournament coming up this weekend. So we had two winners. Well, first and second place got free entry into the Gate tournament this weekend. And first place was Pi from the West and Fraud Squad's Fraud Unoku. We couldn't get either of them on though, to talk about the tournament itself, but I don't know if anybody could tell us a little bit more about the tournament, you know, Double R, Carl, and anybody? How it really went down?
I really would know much about
Who came on?
Ryan went.
I went and helped them set up, and then I had to leave now, so I'm not really sure. I don't think it had any problems, it's just that the room he was using now is kind of hot now, so I think that's the only thing. But nobody really complained. I think it turned out good because when I reached, we originally had planned to have like three screens, so he told me when I run out fast now.
Yeah.
When I reached, it had like about five.
Okay.
So which was good now. So I don't think it had any problems. Everything runs smooth and yeah, that's kind of chill.
So men bring their own systems, or they just had five?
Yeah,
systems?
But some men bring their own systems. Where we was always organized to have at least eight, so okay. It have the normal room. Where the fellas who like not that like good a player, what I mean, they're still learning and thing. They'll go in that room, and then on the next room we had where the tournament was taking place now. So it had like a casual setup on the side too.
Okay.
So men still could have one fun thing now. At least that is what I think, yeah. Cause when I reach it was now in the finals, and them fellas just real playing that, so I'm not sure what it happened. Even though the finals was going on, men really wasn't taking that one.
Yeah, all for real.
Yeah, men really didn't take it on because they don't know the loss of them, they're sitting down and real playing that, so. But it was good, you know what I mean?
So, like, give us a little heads up on, like, what the attendance was like. I know the east side, we couldn't make it that time, but I know the west men come down.
See, right, I think attendance now was the I ain't sure because when I reached out, some men leave already. I don't think so. I would say it had like about 25 people.
Okay, yeah, that's
so
good.
Yeah, but not everybody entered the tournament, obviously. Now, based on what they see in the brackets, I didn't really see the brackets to see how much men really entered. Now, so
that's good. I should have pulled up the brackets beforehand.
Yeah,
Graphic, can you get me the brackets on that? Why are we talking this? You're not too busy.
Yeah, what kind of it?
Alright. Okay. So yeah, I really wanted to talk to Fraud about like how he trained and thing went before this tournament and thing. Like, he was one of the guys I wanted to talk to before, because I know he used to play a little bit of Street Fighter 4, like online and thing, but he didn't come out to much tournaments until like the late half in Ultra.
Yeah.
So like I wanna know what the kind of training needs to go through for like tournaments. I know you all probably help him out to do training online and stuff.
Yeah.
If he did anything, like
I can't talk to him, but he told me he was real practicing, and that's one thing.
Okay.
Real
practicing, so. And he's still playing Nash, right?
Yeah, but yeah. He still mix up his characters now. I'm not sure who he's be playing, but more than likely, yeah, Nash.
These days he playing Urien for like fun and something. Like,
okay.
If it's not Nash,
yeah. I mean, yeah, the game's still young and everybody's still trying to find the, you know, the bearings and something, the character. Even though you're playing a character right now, like a year down the line, then that mightn't be a character, you know?
Yeah.
So, we'll see how that goes. And probably play birdie throughout the whole thing, I believe.
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Based on what I saw, at least in the tournament fight itself, yeah, you play birdie right through.
Right now it's on
YouTube, but I didn't want to post it because it was what I got from Twitch was real sticky, man. I really don't know what's been going on with the internet by that place. But,
oh,
well, right. They could watch it, but it real glitchy, man.
So it's on Twitch.
Well, I'll put it on my channel, so I could post it, you know, just have it there. But...
Alright, okay. Let's get down here. Try the link in the Skype, Fiddle Man. Okay, so I don't really have any videos on Pi Buddy to reference or anything. I don't really know how he plays, but he seems to be doing like well at every tournament he enters, and he was always a strong player, and I'm glad to see now he's doing much better in 5.
Yeah.
Like, he'll be on top. I know he was a little frustrated that he's not getting to play all the top players at one event, but like that will come now. Like that'll come in time. It's just not easy for everybody right now. People have stuff to do, and sometimes things clash, you know. But,
yeah.
I hope you come out to the community sweat. I hope you all come out too. Cause
I'll definitely be
out.
Yeah, yeah. I come in. I could not come in last one because I had to go by family.
Yeah. I know.
I'm trying to come this one. Yeah, Sundays be a kind of hard day to be honest.
Yeah, sure.
That's why we put most of our events on like a Saturday, you know.
Yeah, but that will change though. Like I'm gonna try to come out. Well, gonna come out to the community sweat, and if Bookie have anything in December, definitely gonna try to come out to that too. Just to gain some games with you, cause I wanna I wanna play all and
I haven't really played you. Yeah.
What's that?
I remember playing you like a good set.
No, we never played like tournaments or anything. We just played like a couple times online. But that's it. Need to gain some games.
But this month IRL stuff coming up, so we ain't gonna have no booty sweat this month because we can have something there.
Alright, well.
We have no choice but not to have something this month.
Ryan, if you have the brackets posted in the chat.
Brackets? God. Yes, I ain't know where to find that, man. Let me see if I can find it. I gotta search through Facebook for that.
Mm.
Wait now, yeah. Let...
Yeah. Oh, shit. Shut it down.
That me, sorry.
Alright, okay.
A man reactor went off there.
Yeah, sorry.
That is the problem.
Any lab here.
I was thinking about this thing, I think
I'll go to
last
big bun too, yes?
I don't know if it was last podcast or any podcast before this where Marcus came on and he bring up a point that even though we had the community sweat and everybody gets a player and things like that, certain men wasn't satisfied because they want to do certain things and they can't really do it with other people, you know, hounding them in a sense. Like, let's say he want to run a first to 10 with Furman or something. Can't really do that because, you know, you want to give everybody a chance and stuff like that. So I was thinking that maybe, remember we used to do the first to fives, Gruff?
Yeah.
I was thinking that, like, on the side of, like, everybody will bring their consoles and stuff and we'll have or set up something for Street Fighter, but, like, the mainstream, we should dedicate it to, like, matches like that. Like, beforehand, we plan matches. Plan the fives. I say, Callum, want to play me. Like, we have a first to five with Callum.
Yeah.
On stream, on your system now. Like, you know, so men could get the practice they want now.
Yeah, we could do that.
And not just sit around and play around. Although the vibes be good, everybody know how it is be. Everybody in here was at some kind of event. And you know it is be good vibes. But like, sometimes men want to actually grind and learn matchups and play certain players and things. So I think we should like dedicate some, at least one setup to that. So I'm gonna make a post about that.
Big boy corner.
The big boy table. We could dedicate to sets men want to play now. If men want to call out anybody and get some matches on, that would be good.
Call out.
You like that one? You like it?
Colour, like yeah, like bombing here and there.
Yeah, so call out to the maker, Colour.
let me keep quiet before I get
Yeah, but you see, but what I say, I agree with that. But you see, if men were that kind of fight, or they bring all the setup and organize that kind of fight too.
Yeah, yeah.
It's how the men who go on the stream too now, but that first 10 gonna take a hell long.
Yeah, nah, we won't see it so long.
Nah, 10 is too much.
You know what I mean? 10 is plenty.
That, but in retrospect, in that argument we're now bringing that. That wasn't really the argument, though. For me and Marcus were saying the same thing, right? That wasn't the argument. The argument was that, okay, all of us come together, right? And the same way how it is, we say you want to get in our first to 10 or our first to 20 or whatever, right? Two people said, I'm going to play our first to 20 last time, right? They said, I'm going to play our first to 20. And a man, one of them, gave up to go and buy food. So when that one get up, the other one say, well, he going in the bathroom. So two men sit down and say, well, all right, they go play in the meantime. Them fellas literally get two games.
And then they come back.
And then they come back and ask back to start back to play.
Right, so yeah, hear this, right? So for me, when I go any of them event, all them fellas go tell you, I have a big mouth. So I just tell them fellas, it's first to three. If you don't like that, you had to leave. But if big men, you seen two men sit down playing first to 20 and you ain't say nothing, they go play the first to 20. It's simple as that. But you had to tell them,
no,
hey.
No, no, men was asking for, you know, let me get a game, thing.
Just now. Pull out the plug for me, TV, and tell them what they can't.
Nah, but you see, we ain't trying to get into that. Because you talking about, you are our big mouth, but. Ah, boy.
But I ain't saying no, but at the end of the day, you come for a community set, not two men to sit down and play first to 20. That's been the problem. That's been the problem with me here in Trinidad, because we have no shit in discipline. it's simple. It has no discipline. If you know you come here for that, you can't sit down and play first to 20, man. Yeah. And nobody, if all at once, they leave it and let it be, it will be. So if these two men sit down here to play first to 20, they go play first to 20 if nobody jump them. I fed up, see that? You know, how much time I sit down to play game with men and I end up playing first to 22? But nobody telling me to move, so I go sit down and play.
Yeah.
I get my belly full from me sweating. So like, that's what I tell you, men had to open them out.
Yeah.
It's not to make no scene and thing, but you know.
Yeah. A lot of the people that were there, they not the regulars too, now they don't really know people, so they kind of, you know, they're shy to ask for game and thing. Like,
that is why it's even easier to open your mouth and say, well, boy, I come here for a sweat and I can't get a sweat.
Not everybody mouth big like
that. I know, but it's not okay. What I mean, my mouth big is not a really gain or fight and thing, just that. it's not like that now, you know. But men can be welling on our TV by their madness,
hard construction.
At least somebody had moderated that now. At least that for my system. When I'm still let me switch to try and move. I know salty. You gotta wait till it. Yeah.
I think it should have like a separate setup for like long sets now. But yeah, obviously not no full set. Not first to 20, not going to work out there.
Yeah, well, man.
You do fives.
It's a fight first to fives, dog. And like have
like a rough incident.
Exactly. So.
So we have that on the stream, but all the other setups you do like first two, first three, and every move now, you know?
Yeah.
So I think we'll definitely aim for that.
I don't really have a problem with that, right? So at the end of the day, I was just getting kicks and laughing at everybody.
Yeah.
But if it is we come together to do this, right? All are we playing game years now? For men who come from the arcade days, you line up 20 men to play one game. As they lost one game, you give up. Move. You know?
Right.
And you rotate. You know, it's like you weed nowadays, you know, puff, puff, pass, you know? I just sell out myself today. Hard luck there.
Yeah, we'll definitely enforce that this time around. Like, yeah, I think first the two is fine.
That is the enforce, bro. Trust me. That's how the men who after tell them, hey, let's make sure I watch the game and tell them. Yeah, tell the men, go and block the TV. It's not no scene to make jokes with it.
The only thing I vex about is like they didn't bring that to my attention while we were there. Now. So I thought the event run normal. Now. I didn't know if people had that kind of problems.
That was the only thing that happened. Other than that, everything was great. Yeah. They didn't have anything else, but that was the only thing that happened on that day. That was the only thing that, the only little mishap that it had. And then men stopped, men even studying that because it had so much of a different thing to do.
Yeah.
Right? That, you know, you're just walking from one thing. Look, I was supposed to even play King of Fighters 14. I even get a chance.
Mm-hmm.
And, but I was so interested in what them fellas was doing on the game. I didn't care that I didn't get to play. You know, I was watching them fellas and just freaking amazement to them. Because the kind of thing, how, well, where I know King of Fighters from, to what is it could do now in the game,
mm-hmm.
where it real, real, real different, boy. And I actually enjoy that, you know, seeing that. And I was watching the game to see exactly, you know, what the hitboxes is like, how the movement of the character is and thing. And then, because I don't have a PS4 anymore. So just watching this was kind of cool for me, you know what I mean?
Yeah. No, that's a good point to bring up there. Like, I didn't get to play everything, but it was nice seeing all these games around. I really feel like an arcade, you know? Like, it's always games, different games all over. Every direction you look at a different game. And that is something, even though we say it on the group and make posts about it and things, people don't really understand that the community sweat is not just a Street Fighter sweat or a Mortal sweat. Right? That is whatever you want to play, just bring it and play, right? But like you were saying that some guys asked you like why are you going there? You don't play any of the new school games.
Who's that? Me and Jokamon?
Yeah, you.
Yeah. Well, like, yeah, and
that's something for everybody then, you know?
Yeah, that's something. Alright, but alright, off the top of my head, right? Street Fighter 5, Street Fighter 4, King of Fighters 14, Smash Brothers, Tekken Tournament. Tekken Tag Tournament, Samurai Shodown 2, Samurai Shodown 4, Samurai Shodown 3, Street Fighter Turbo, Street Fighter Super Turbo, Killer Instinct 1, Killer Instinct 2, all these games we play on that day.
Yeah, every time you look at that old school setup, there's a different game was running. Like, such a
men was playing Super Contra, it had men playing Power, our partner was running some Metal Slug at a time and he get fed up because nobody was playing with him.
Everything on our machine was.
World realizes over 20 games I now called it.
Yeah.
Right, that was playing on that day. Right, so even if it is you don't play Street Fighter, it have something for you to play. It always has something for you to play. It has something to do. It must have some game. Oh, and I forget Mortal Kombat. It had Mortal Kombat, right? And I actually put on Mortal Kombat 3 and Mortal Kombat Ultimate for a fellow to play, and he was playing that for a little while, and nobody wasn't playing against him, so he take it off and he went back playing Last Blade.
Okay, all right.
Mm-hmm.
So. I just get out to the people in the group, if who didn't make it out to the last one. If you're listening to the podcast now, you could if you're into old school. Into old school games, we have old school games. Just have to come, just say where you wanna play. I mean, go have men there who was fans of it too. You know. So yeah. We're gonna try to enforce that. I'd like to have like another setup though. I think we should really try to look into getting another arcade setup like that. As well as yours, yeah.
That no problem. That could come. Yeah. Bring two of them one time. That no worries.
Yeah.
It's two here, no?
It's two?
Yeah, it's two here.
It's six.
All right. Well, I only know two.
I don't know yet. All of that. I was gonna say like
that. It had Street Fighter EX, I think.
Everything on our machine.
Have it on the system, but we didn't run it because the that particular emulator that we was using on that day, because I wasn't even using my computer, that system, it is running slow. So it's kind of glitch now. Right? If you're playing the EX1, it is work real good, but it have a stupid glitch in Guile's stage or Alan Snyder's stage and Blade Aim stage. When it is a jump sometime, you go end up on the other side of the screen.
Oh, okay. Oh, right? Nah.
You know, but other than that, you can play the game, you know, if you just want to play it, right? And the EX2, this run real slow. Like, you know, you could literally ring for a magic, walk, go get something to eat, brush your teeth, come back. Then you but other,
what's the way to do this, though?
Yeah, but while we were speaking just now, while you were trying to do the PS1 emulator. So if it is a pawn the PS1 emulator, everything will come straight across and we just play it like if it's PlayStation. Instead of going on, I really don't want to take out my PlayStation and modify it back because I catch my tail to wire back them controls the last time, so I ain't going through that again.
Nah, yeah, don't go through that. We'll figure out something.
Hey. People have laptops. Let's use laptops.
When we when it's wet.
Marcus on the call.
Yeah, Marcus.
Marcus on the call.
Ito.
Go ahead. I just said you know Marcus here.
Milo was saying something.
Oh.
I say when we start getting into more into the sweater and stuff like people can like donate stuff now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They donate PlayStation, the old school games and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Cause I have an N64 here, Lyman there, not doing anything. So.
Yeah. What was anybody the talking about? Anybody have an AM3 motherboard to donate right now? That's all they're talking about donate.
Yeah, man. Hey.
No, Miguel.
Good to ask, you know.
Yeah, the ox.
I'm looking for a drive right now.
You could get it. What size are drive here?
Whatever size.
Right, no sin. Yeah, I know when I see you to get it, but most likely you'll get it on the day.
Community sweat,
But right, that what I mean. You'll see money day, so just remind me and I'll go bring it for you. I think it's a 500. It's SATA drive, right?
Cool.
I'm looking for an AM3 motherboard right now. If anybody has one that they can DDR3. brother, we was talking donation. Supertech don't donate nothing.
Oh god, Trini Salon, bye. Alright.
Alright.
So yeah, Jason here?
Yeah, are you right here?
Yeah,
your mic are also off. If you want to touch on Git, you know, it's this weekend, so I don't know how many times you'll get to plug it again. So like, our last plug. So you gotta say about the events.
Well, the Bayesians coming down for Smash Brothers, so that is our topic we could focus on. Yeah.
Smash Man down here already?
Nah, they coming now. I think it's the Friday.
Alright, cool.
They're going to come from behind and smash.
Our local Smash players ready for them?
Well, a few people added me and starting to talk trash and thing already to me. Mm. But and like for the I think it was the AnimeCon that went.
Yeah.
I think the best person we hired Trinidad, he come forth. So right, so I told them all I need to train more like people like Mega Man and stuff like that, characters, because they're not familiar with the characters. No.
Yeah.
Right, so
cast it on there and say, well, like, I can't fight Mega Man. And
yeah.
I said,
yeah,
I just lost to Mega Man over and over. And I had to do some more.
Yeah, because when he was in the sweat, he almost telling me, like, he had problems fighting Mega Man. Now. He don't know what Mega Man could do now. So I was like, well, learn the matchup, go and practice with the character and see what he could do.
Yep.
It's because I play him with Kirby and, like, I was getting some matches on him now, cause like he have this character that he's not familiar with, so he getting licks.
Yeah.
Right. So he
just don't have experience.
Yeah, he don't have experience.
Yeah.
At all. So.
So all right. Well, I mean, yes, they try and level up before the guys come this weekend.
Yeah. I think it's four Bayesians.
Oh gosh, come on, take all the place, bro. All right.
Yeah, four Bayesians. One was down here. He was in the Salty Fish tournament. He came fourth, I believe. Yeah.
Cool. Yes. And you Mega Man coming on?
He coming for sure.
Yeah, Michael coming.
He qualified.
Anybody coming on for Street Fighter?
Not to my knowledge.
I don't know.
Jason can answer that?
Nah, the people that were supposed to come can't come again.
Oh, okay.
I dealing with the hurricane that passed Dominican Republic.
Okay. So what about these guys from St. Lucia? Are they coming for the Street Fighter tournament too as well?
Final word, they can't make again.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Wow. I don't know. Well, I mean, what about the guys in here? Carlin, you going now?
Yeah, I'll just play on the day.
So okay.
I'll go now.
Also, yeah. Carlin will be in the tournament then. Nice.
Yeah.
Anybody else local going besides Carlin?
I want to find out.
I'm going.
Oh, Ryan.
I want to pay on the day to get in.
Huh? Is that
Jason?
Is that an entry fee to the building, Jason?
$100. Right, you can pay on the day to get in?
According to the capacity of the location, so you had to come early to get in. Just recommend.
Oh, okay.
You have anything you want to like say about the tournament coming up? Any other plans? We see the belt. Anybody who any here didn't see the belt? The belt look alright.
Yeah, saw it.
Checking it out. I want to see who gonna be wearing this belt by the end of the day.
For the Kula belt. I'm a money on Carlin.
Carlin?
Yeah, I'm a money on Carlin. I seen Carlin with that belt.
I want to see Enlightened Lord. You'll be in the tournament?
Well, Rance, you'll be there too?
No, no, Enlightened Lord.
Enlightened.
No, I don't think he'll be there.
Oh, I ain't from my wife.
I ain't seen him play now, so.
Yeah, he said he just real busy with work on.
Okay, still fighting up with our fan?
yeah, he's still playing.
Yeah, time to change our character. What's the time to change? Yeah. I respect what you do. You fight up with the man for like a year, so new character now. Oh gosh. What else you want to talk about? So y'all
Well, Jason, you get Jason a chance to plug his event again.
Yeah. Well, Jason, you good?
Jason, you go now. You're the floor now.
Alright, well, yeah. So far, just the three Bajans that confirmed they are coming in from Friday, and the three from Bullet coming in today, and Balance 2 coming in Friday. So that's two countries that will be represented at the event. We see the rest of them coming out next year. So far, here Aruba and Dominican Republic. Hopefully, Jamaica should come out next year for especially the three Street Fighter tournament. In terms of the event itself, it's shaping up. All the information is out there. I added some new info to the FPC group about ways in which that I discussed last time about sponsorship towards the event for those of you still interested in participating in the tournament but didn't have all the funds to do so. So that's up on the group right now, so anybody who's interested could check on that. So you have the option for those entering the Street Fighter and the FIFA and the Smash Brothers. To that the exhibitors on the day that will be selling goods and advertising their services has agreed to sponsor a player throughout the tournament, and they would pay part of the money to enter. So instead of paying the entire $500, they have the option to pay $300. And for the Immortal and the Naruto, instead of paying the $300, they could pay $200. They would have paid the balance, and you would then represent their company at the tournament itself. So that was one of the options people could have chosen to enter the tournament, or just pay all the money and get in there. That's about it. Besides that, the other post I posted was that because we facilitated the stay for Team Guadeloupe, they have invited us to their tournament as well. That would be the second week in November. So any people that are interested in flying out there, all you'd have to do is purchase a ticket to Guadeloupe, and that would be it. You don't have to pay anything else. Just walk with some spending money and enjoy yourself. You'll be able to challenge some Europeans, some people from the US as well. So it's a good proving ground for those who feel the need to go away and practice, play against some other players that they normally don't play. And enjoy yourself. A little small day, 6 days vacation in another country, French speaking country.
Okay.
And so, anybody interested could just call me, let me know, and we could try to buy tickets as soon as possible.
How many are you looking to fly out?
We could bring 3 to 4 people.
Okay.
You could bring 3 to 4 people? It's 2 pour les voulez chez toi, les studios de France.
Oh, God, Lord.
All right, Miguel Gwyn.
Yeah, as you mean.
So, three people. All
right. All right,
so if anybody want to go, just let me know so we can start to purchase tickets. I also had an idea, probably, if we, whoever won the gate tournament, we could have, like, put up, do, like, a, just like how we do the sweats right now, do a little sweater, do a, start a little fundraiser to send one of the best players that we have for their tournament. And only tournaments I have show is the Street Fighter, King of Fighters, Smash Brothers, Naruto, some driving games. There's a lot of different events, so if you're there, you get to participate in two of the tournaments there. I posted all the prizes from the top three that you could win. Well, I see the Street Fighter and the T5 is the two largest tournaments prizes. So it's just a nice chance for people to get the experience and try to utilize the community to see if you can send the best players in Trinidad and Tobago.
Okay. It says the second week in November?
Yeah, I think that's the 12th or the 13th, that weekend.
Okay.
Yeah, the 12th and the 13th.
All right. We'll definitely plug that so anybody interested in going.
Yeah.
12th and 13th are this November this year?
Yeah.
Yeah, now, boy. Pressure.
Yeah, a little soon, but I mean, people might want to go. Mm-hmm. People might be available. And it's always good to travel and play in competition.
Mm. Yeah. I know one person say they're interested already, so we just looking for about two more people who are interested. If they can't get the funds, we will try to organize within ourselves to see if we can send somebody.
Okay. Yeah, that's some good news. I like when the players get the opportunity to go from places. Like, if you have an experience, you really should. Okay, so that's it for the get. How the tournament like shaping up? Everything coming along smoothly?
With just the exception of the Morsel community, every other tournament looking like it come into place. But a lot of people more expressed pain on the day of the tournament. Yeah. Which I was trying to
avoid.
Avoid, because that would then extend the tournament when it's supposed to finish and all these things. So hope you're okay on the day and make sure everybody come on time so we could actually get the brackets up and the tournament could start quickly.
Yeah. Okay. So once it once you have enough setups and enough people enter and stuff, it should run smoothly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's good to know. We'd like to have you on the weekend after the tournament as well to tell us more about it, like how it was and stuff like that. Any little thing like that. Anybody have any questions? Carolyn, Double R, y'all gonna be there?
I'm good.
No?
Yeah. What time is the tournament itself starting?
The tournament itself is supposed to start at 11 a.m.
Okay.
12 for the latest.
Alright.
Okay. So we want those who haven't registered for any tournaments as well, they could come in long before the event is supposed to start. The event starts at 10 a.m. They could come arrive at 8 and we could have people who didn't enter register one time.
Alright. And so there's gonna be stuff for everybody there. And even if you're not in any tournament, there's gonna be stuff on the side to do. So yeah, it should be a fun day. Regardless.
Yeah, go have a lot of free play, games to play. We had the test out, we will have the main stage where you have some other games running as well. A stream to go on to, plus those of people that will be there or not. At the venue itself, the stream will be there along with Yella, the social media. Those good people actually post up things and it will run on the screen.
Okay.
Send a message out during the stream. You can send it out, and the actual message will go on the live stream itself for people to see.
All right. Let's go. All right. So, you have anything else? Any like last things you wanna plug about the gate on?
That's about it. Just
to see how it plays out now.
Yeah, just to see how it plays out and hopefully see as much support as possible towards the event.
Mm-hmm.
And like I was saying, there will be people present to see exactly how big the gaming community is in Trinidad and Tobago.
Okay.
So they will know exactly how they would put things in place for next year.
Mm-hmm.
What a tell me? If I can say this one thing, the top two games that shows the most support, two games they would run strongly next.
Alright. They'll be behind those games though.
Yes.
Yeah. Alright. That's good. That's good to see. Mm. I like they're trying to make it more, you know, appeal to more broader audiences now. Let people see what gaming really is. It's not just people sitting up playing, you know, Super Mario Brothers, nothing anymore. It's like it's competition. It's like a sport now, you know? So it's cool to see. Let's want to touch one last time on the community thread. The first to fives that we're gonna try to start. If anybody have any challenges, to go ahead and make it on the group, the FGCTT. Yeah, let Gruff know. Gruff gonna be handling the streaming and the whatever that side. So all the sets we'll run it on Gruff system. Everything else is whatever anybody else bring. We'll run it on this. We'll just play games on there. Right? So that way, you know, and if you have any criticism or any feedback you want to give on anything, feel free to do so as well.
Yeah, we want that. We want that.
Yeah. And just want to make it known that the community cell is not for profit. It's not anything. The money each player brings is going towards the renting of the venue, and any extra is going towards the next month. No money is pocketed or anything. Not going to anybody. We always trying to improve the community. So definitely come on show your support on the 6th, that'll be the second one, and people who are there will get a feel for the venue and they know we have space for a lecture or something. And I think we should also try to kind of shape the place up a little better, because we just went and put stuff anywhere. You know what I mean? Like, although it was a little tidy and stuff, we kind of had setups all over the place now. Like, if you could kind of organize where we're going to put stuff better next time, that'll be good too. And I'll get more of everything. Because we had spot for more. We could have like a couple of Tekken setups. We had like 4 sheets. We could probably get our next one. I don't know. That might be too much.
Four sheets.
Smash.
Yeah,
had like 4 sheets.
1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 4 sheets in 3.
Yeah. I don't know. Yeah, so the men really come out, try and get the old school men to come out too. I see the old school men, they take notice of it. They're on the FGC and they're posting up little old school videos and things like that. Hope we get some recording and things going on next time too.
Mm-hmm.
Some different.
Alright. Next thing is Nazi. Nazi event on the 20th or next month.
Yeah. And he not told him to...
Nah, he not wrong right now. So we go plug it for him.
Alright, yeah. You wanna plug it right now or you wanna wait until someone next?
Well, if next time or whatever. You have plenty of time.
Yeah. So, it's after the community set, right? Is the 11th or something?
Yeah. The 20th.
20th, also. Yeah,
20th.
Yeah, I was way off. Yeah. Alright, the 20th. So, yeah, we have time to talk to him about this event and thing. And we have... your tournament. What's the name of your tournament again? Game On?
Yeah, Game On 5. December 18th.
Right.
We have doing it in City Hall. We have, I think it's like 6 games you're doing. I'm going back to the old school Street Fighter 4. I see a certain man vote for it. So you have a setup for Street Fighter 4. I see Calder, I see Marcus.
Well, Hurtful is man saying old school Street Fighter 4.
Yeah, they call it old school. Yeah, it's old school. Yeah. Right, we have Mortal Kombat.
Street Fighter 4 is like 8 years old, man.
Yeah.
So you see, yeah, you could call it old school. Yeah, Street Fighter 4, Street Fighter 5.
It's so old, all of us played it last year.
Yeah. We have
Mortal. That never happened. Nobody.
So the games, we have Tekken Tag, we have Mortal Kombat, Street Fighter 4, Street Fighter 5, and Smash Brothers. I think I have one more game. I kind of squeeze in another game. I think it's for the Tekken community. Well, not for the Tekken, sorry, for the Killer Instinct community. I tell them if you can get 10 men, we could run I could do something for them. I could do like a pot tournament or something. Just for them to get the experience on the field.
I will enter the KI.
Alright, so.
Just for entering sick.
Yeah.
Just for supporting.
I gave up playing that game.
Right, so game on 5 on the December 18th. Always look out for that.
So FGC, honestly, like, now is the best time to be in the FGC. You have endless events coming up.
Yeah.
I'll make sure and support. Trying to come out. So I want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. I know we didn't have much to talk about tonight, but it was still a good podcast. We got the last plug on Gate until this weekend. We'll see how it goes. Everybody looking forward to it. I hope it's a successful event. The community sweat, definitely looking forward to that. And I would have liked to touch on the Boki sweat a bit more, but we couldn't get either Fraud Squad or not Fraud Squad, Fodunoko or Pai to come on. Hopefully we'll hear more about that. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. Wishing both those guys luck. Guys definitely want it and they're hungry for it, so it would be a good morale boost if they were to win like the biggest tournament in Shippeta 5 for the year.
I wish everybody luck tonight,
and we'll definitely try to do our next one next weekend after the aftermath of Gates. Hope we could get the same panel, if not more people.
Yeah, I will be there. I'll be taking out some pictures and getting some feedbacks, and also giving some news on the FGC about how certain things going on in the event and stuff now.
All right. Thanks a lot for joining us, fellas. Until next time.
All right, fellas. Blessed.
Yeah, man.
All right. Good night, everybody.
Yeah, fellas. Later.